Hey y'all. So some people were asking me how they should do their hair and makeup for a day job. So I thought I would help you out. So first of all, you want to do your hair so that it's curly and beautiful, but it wants to be not exactly wild and free. So you just take a clip and then clip a little tiny bit up like this. And then voila, you've got work hair. And I always recommend, if you have a day job, to do gold at work because it suggests wealth. So you want to do gold rather than silver. All right, so for first-time watchers, as you know, when I'm about to do makeup, I only have one set of fingernails on just so I can open things. So get over it. All right, so what we're gonna do first is we're gonna look at the eyes. So as you can see, I have a little bit of black shadow on from my day, but we don't have to take off the makeup, we just have to layer it. So we're gonna layer over it. What I'm gonna do is I have this beautiful blue color, and since I have on a red shirt, blue will look really good because it is a primary color. So I'm going to take this blue and get in that shadow, get a lot of it in my brush, and then put it over the black. So this is a really good eyeshadow, so it should cover. If you don't have as good of an eyeshadow, it may not cover as well. So the lesson there is just get good eyeshadow. You need to invest in your beauty. I think I speak from experience because I've been putting on makeup for so long. I actually went to a high school that has the most beauty queens in the nation. I mean, the most beauty queens come out of that high school than anywhere else in the nation. So I have been competing with lovely girls for all my life, and I won. All right, so I have this blue on. Now, as we all know, I don't really have a day job, but I have been in adult films where there's an office, and I love playing the sexy secretary. It's one of my favorite types of roles. So here's this nice blue, and I would recommend that at work you do the bottom part blue, and then we want to add a little depth to your eyes so it says, I'm a secretary or I'm an office worker. But so much more. So how we do that is we just take a darker blue. So as you can see, this is much darker than this one. And we just put that color in the crease. So that would be like right here when you open your eye. So it's just darken that crease. I like to imagine all you people doing this with me. So there's millions of people doing makeup together. I just think that is a beautiful feminine power, enhancing our beauty. Or males, you know, if you want to put on makeup. It's up to you. Anyone's free to watch. All right, so I have this darker shade on, and now we want to lighten it up and say, I'm rich, I like sassy red, I'm refined, I'm fun, but I'm also light, bright and sassy. So that means that we need to add a little silver into our outfit. So I'm going to take another brush and I am going to put this silver in the brush and then I'm going to put the silver right underneath my eyebrow. I may have to redraw my eyebrow in just because I got a little bit of shadow on it, but that's all right. That's easy to do. Again, we want to build up and not take off. The built up look gives it a nicer base. I feel like makeup's kind of like oil painting. You know, I always think about Bob Ross when I'm doing my makeup. And I'm thinking, you know, if he can do it, I can do it. I feel like every day, at least once a day, I'm painting all sorts of happy trees on my face. All right, so here we are. Now you can see that I got some little extra on my cheek. What I'm gonna do is easy. You just take another brush and you just whoop, wipe it off. Wipe it off. And the other side, just make sure it comes off because we don't want any of them dark circles in our eyes. That's for tired people. We're not tired. All right. So here you are. You got this nice open look. Now we got to finish it off with lipstick. And lipstick always wants to match the outfit. So we've got this blue. We've got this nice red and gold. You may think, oh, she's going to do gold lips, but absolutely not. Your accessories can speak for themselves. So we're going to do a bright red. And what you want to do first with the lips, as we've talked about a million times, is you want to line it first, and you want to line a little bit outside of the lip. Right here. So as you can see, like, if I have this side lined and it's bigger, my lips look bigger and juicier and just more kissable. So that is why that look is attractive. There we are. Beautifully lined lips. All right, you just want to make sure everything's even. It doesn't matter if the lip liner is thicker in some places or whatever, because we're just going to cover it up. It's just like coloring by the dots. These are the dots, and now you just color it in. So I have some red lipstick. We start with that. I'm going to put this lipstick on. In between the lines, please. I just want to lick that right off. Alright, now we want to make it, so this is just kind of hoo-ha, whatever, normal. So now we want to really pizzazz the outfit up and say, hey, I'm the queen of this office. So we want to take a gloss that has glitter in it and put it on. Yes, yes, yes. Beautiful. Oh, I got a little. There we go. All right. So here we are. And if you still need it glossier, of course you should have another red gloss in your lipstick bag. So you just take it out. If I can open it. Whew. See, that's why you can't have nails on both hands. It's hard. Oh, yeah. And then you just get it even shinier. I just love so much shine because just random strangers will come up and kiss you. And they'll just say, I'm sorry, ma'am. You were just so kissable, so juicy, that I just had to kiss you. I just love that. All right. So if you have any questions, you can just leave it in the comments down below. And I hope to see you soon.